Holy Eucharist this morning begins on page 1. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Here, Jesus said the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
The confession is found on page 2. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord of all power and might, who art the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts a love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. So now, Israel, give heed to the statutes and ordinances that I am teaching you to observe, so that you may live to enter and occupy the land that the Lord, the God of your ancestors, is giving you. You must neither add anything to what I command you, nor take away anything from it, but keep the commandments of the Lord your God, with which I am charging you. You must observe them diligently, for this will show your wisdom and discernment to the peoples who, when they hear all these statutes, will say, "Surely this great nation is a wise and discerning people. For what other great nation has a God so near to it as the Lord our God is whenever we call to him? And what other great nation has statutes and ordinances, and as just as this entire law that I am setting before you today. But take care and watch yourselves closely, so as neither to forget the things that your eyes have seen, nor to let them slip from your mind all the days of your life. Make them known to your children and children's children. Thus is the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of James. Every generous act of giving with every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In fulfillment of his own purpose, he gave us birth by the word of truth, that we would become a kind of first fruits of his creatures. You must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger, for your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourselves of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. But be doers of the word and not merely hearers to deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, They are like those who look at themselves in a mirror, for they look at themselves and, on going away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. If any think they are religious and do not bridle their tongues, but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. Thus is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the Lord be on your lips and in your heart, understanding the gospel of God of peace, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now, when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the scribes and Pharisees asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of our elders, but eat with defiled hands?" He said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines.' You abandon the commandment of God and hold on to human tradition." Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these evil things come from within, and they defile a person." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Please be seated. There was a time when the colic always went with the lessons. That doesn't always happen anymore, but this morning actually it does. We pray that we might learn true religion. And that's what we hear in the reading from James. I like James. I'm very fond of the letter of James. As I said several times, Martin Luther was not. Martin Luther didn't like James because it undermined his theology that we are saved by grace alone. So words such as "be hearers of the word," not only hearers of the word, but doers, flew right against everything. So he really didn't want people to read James, just like Thomas Cranmer didn't want people to read Revelation. But it's still there, and it speaks very profoundly. James, throughout the epistle, gives wonderful reflective advice for us to consider. The Venerable Bede, who did not just write the ecclesiastical history of the English Church shortly after the Council of Whitby, the first English history, but He actually wrote other things. And he wrote in a reflection on the Epistle of James, "It is good to see that James has added the words before God the Father, because there are plenty of people who appear to be religious in the sight of others, but are wicked as far as God is concerned. Spiritual happiness is gained not by empty words, but putting our good intentions into practice." Putting our good intentions into practice. Yes, he adds before God that God judges our faith and how we live our lives differently than other people might. So it's a question of whom will you serve? Chrysostom says that there's a difference between religion and faith. Faith is a part of what we believe. Our religion is how we live the faith we believe. Today we are remembering that difference and remembering that in God's eyes it is about bridling the tongue, being reflective, and caring for others, including the widow and the orphan. You'll notice that this is like the second week in this month. It's been like a show and tell. There's a set of vestments out in the narthex this morning. And we use them Trinity Sunday and Christ the King 3 times a year. They were made in 1999. In those days, St. James Day, it still falls on the 25th, but St. James made a big deal of its patronal feast day. And we had the vestry would have a reception, and you know, the choir usually sang. It was the full part. Well, in 1999, it was the 450th anniversary of the first Book of Common Prayer. So we decided we would observe that 450th anniversary on our feast day in the heat of July. So we're going to do a sung solemn mass according to the prayer book of 1549 on July 25th. And so the vestments were made for that occasion. For the day, the choir learned the Marbach mass setting, which was the first mass setting in English. Was in the 1940 hymnal. Parts of it are still in the hymnal now. But they learned the Marbach setting in its original form, including the creed of the day. The altar was put up against the wall on 3 steps. There was a carpet before, and everything was practiced. Practiced and practiced. Because we want it right, and since we were sort of consumed with washing of bowls and pots and hands, I guess, but because it's a dance. The priest is on the top step, the deacon's on the second step, the subdeacon's on the 3rd step, and the acolytes are on the floor. And not only that, sometimes the sacred ministers in a row, sometimes they're 1, 2, 3, sometimes they're facing each other, sometimes they're not. The deacon prepares the altar, the elements over at a side altar, and then they get processed over, and then there's this paten dance, because they thought in the Middle Ages that the paten was like more holy than the Eucharist, because that's where it happened. So it was like the focus, and so people got very superstitious about the Eucharist. And so in the Serum Rite, during the prayer of consecration, the priest slipped the host off the paten behind his back, passed it down to the deacon, who passed it behind her back to the subdeacon, who then stood it and she showed us that, see, he's not using it today. So there was a whole complicated dance, days and days of practicing and getting it right. We wanted it right. Just like those who strive. But it was 98 degrees in here, and we didn't have air conditioning at the time. So in the middle of the prayer of consecration, down goes the acolyte, bang on the floor. It's like, wow, so much for the dance. And it has something else to be. attentive to than the dead. We often, in the way we live our faith and practice our religion, we forget to look with God's eyes at what we're doing. We should do the best we can, following the traditions to the best of our ability, to live a life that is truly religious, though, is a true reflection of the faith that we profess. God doesn't look on how we practice our religion as we might watch a football game on television. He looks at the heart. He looks at the hands. He looks at the minds. Nothing from the outside can destroy, but we can if we're inattentive to the heart. We are reminded today that our faith is empty words if we don't put our intentions into practice. So that we pray that we may be people who practice our religion by practicing our faith. Not just with acts of worship, but with outstretched hands and hearts, caring for the widow, the orphan, being people of reflection, bridling our tongue, proclaiming the good news of God by deed, and not by it, just by word. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The creed will be found on page 6. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are found on page 8. Almighty God, you have promised that you will come near to us when we come near to you. Cleanse our hands and purify our hearts as we bow before you and bring before you the needs of our world, saying, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for one another as we meet the trials and testing of our faith.
We pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our primate, William, our diocesan bishop, for Joe Morris, our retired bishop, for our companion dioceses of Ecuador Central and Ecuador Litoral, the province of Jerusalem in the Middle East, and for the clergy and people in the diocese on the Anglican cycle of prayer this week. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for Trinity Cathedral, those in the vocational process, clergy celebrating ordination anniversaries, the Ministry of Diocesan Staff, the members and ministries of the Global Goals Task Force, the Deacons Council, Emergency Response Team, and Provincial Synod.
We pray for one another as we meet the trials and testing on our faith. In our pain, give us perseverance. In our ignorance, wisdom. In our doubt, faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. We pray for our families, neighbors, and friends.
We pray for those celebrating birthdays this week, especially Earl Redding, Olivia Mattis, Haley Naroda, Brittany Woodruff, and Joe Noble. The Shrine
us love and humility. Make us quick to listen and slow to anger. Make us doers as well as hearers of your word. Take away envy, ambition, and disorder, and make us peacemakers, full of peace and integrity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those in need inside and outside the church,
especially for all refugees and immigrants, all medical workers, first responders, medical researchers, and all other essential workers. For those displaced and affected in any way by all disasters, and for those working to meet their needs, especially in Haiti and Afghanistan. We pray for awareness of environmental stewardship and justice, and for the outreach ministry of this parish, especially those we serve through cleanings, the Allentown Food Pantry, and the Poor Box Ministry.
For those who care for orphans and widows, for those whose actions meet the needs of those without clothes and daily bread, and those who wear gold rings and fine raiment. We pray for justice in our society, for forgiveness for our favoritism, and for the insight to love those who are rich in faith, yet poor in the eyes of the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our government and for the leaders of the nations,
especially for Joseph, our president, Kamala, our vice president, for members of Congress and the judiciary, for Philip, our governor, and for all elected officials. We pray for the leaders of all nations and those working for peace and nuclear disarmament, and for the safety and well-being of all men and women serving in the armed forces and for their loved ones.
For those who put faith into practice and words into deeds, set a guard over their words and take away the causes of quarrels and fighting. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray in faith for those who are sick and in trouble,
especially for William, Russell, Lindsay, Jacob, Stephanie, Bob, Anthony, Maria, Joanne, Leslie, James, Kirsten, Julie, Linda, Harvey, Judy, Carl, Chad, Ann, Tony, Charlotte, Michael, Kyle, Marion, Tony, and for the health and well-being of all those who are ill with COVID-19. We pray for those who are on the hearts and minds of our cleanings guests, those who live with prolonged illnesses, those preparing for and recovering from surgery, those who are with child, and for all those who mourn and grieve.
For time to pray, for people to pray with, for hands to convey your healing, for prayer to be answered. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We rejoice in our fellowship with all those who, like Abraham, are counted righteous before you, because faith and actions are working together.
We pray for the departed, especially for Calvin and for Ken Miller. The sanctuary candle burns in honor of the Lord's presence in the Blessed Sacrament and in loving memory of Joseph P. Pownall II.
Bring us together with the poor and all your saints to inherit the kingdom you promised to those who you love.
We pray this day also especially for those killed at the Abbey Gate at the airport in Kabul this past week, for the Afghans who were killed, and most especially for our troops who were killed at that time, remembering also those who were injured. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in whose hand are the living and the dead, we give you thanks for all your servants who have laid down their lives in the service of our country. Grant to them your mercy and the light of your presence, and give us such a lively sense of your righteous will that the work which you did begin in them may be made perfect. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Please be seated. A few announcements. I didn't announce this earlier, but it's probably a good, just a reminder today. One of the ways that here at Holy Apostles, we heed the words of James this morning is through the Ruth and Naomi Fund, which is a fund and there are envelopes out there if you want to contribute to it, but that funds are reserved in case that we have a widow or a widower that has needs. So we do try and take that very, very seriously. So please remember the Ruth and Naomi Fund if you have any spare cash at any time. Also, please remember that we are gathering envelope. The disaster envelopes are still being received. And those monies will be split. A good portion of that will go to ERD, Episcopal Relief and Development, because we have the opportunity for getting matching money. And then part of that will be used for Afghan relief. Last time we had said well, we would use Episcopal Migrant Ministries, but we have received word from the diocese that the diocese, because of Afghans being at Fort Dix, we're going to have diocesan efforts in resettlement, so we'll probably funnel the money that's being sent for use for Afghan relief to the diocesan program to help people in our own community. So disaster envelopes continue to be in the narthex, and Deacon Denise will be gathering those funds and then sending a check from the parish to the appropriate agencies. Please do note that Tuesday we do serve gleanings. You can still use desserts for that. Then this is a big heads up. The vestry met, so look, the next newsletter is coming out soon. There will be paper copies available if you're not on the email system. So they will be coming up probably at the end of the week, so they'll be available, paper ones will be available next weekend. It will have some important updates for the fall on program. We are scheduled for kickoff Sunday on the 19th. At that time, we'll have registration and we'll be able to better formulate actually what the three classes are going to look like. But we are working on a formation plan, and that will begin on the 19th. But the major change, so get your heads around this one, is that the vestry had a long, thorough discussion about the boutique. The boutique is in November. Last year, instead of doing a one-day event with luncheon and outside vendors and all that, we weren't able to do that. We did instead a five-day event, a couple hours one day, a couple hours another day. And the vestry thought that that was a very few people did an awful lot of work and spent a whole week here, and they really didn't want to do that again. So they wanted to sort of do a one-day event. So then the question was, well, how can we do a one-day event that has some similarity with what we used to do when we know we can't do what we used to do in the space that we have, right? So so the plan was, we'll do a hybrid event. So part of it inside, part of it outside. But you can't really do that in November because it's going to be too cold outside, right? So it's a whole rethink. So get your minds around that. So we don't have a lot of time. It will be October 16th, and it will be a hybrid event. So outside vendors will be able to get spaces out on the lawn. The lunch area will be out on the lawn. Some other things will be out on the lawn. The baskets will be inside because I don't want somebody to, instead of putting a ticket in a plastic cup, taking a basket with them. So I guess I've learned because we've lost gift cards at baskets before that people just take it because they went inside the cellophane. So baskets will be inside. The candy will be inside in case it's warm enough that the chocolate melts and baked goods. But we're still working on it. It's still being flushed out. But we are having something on October 16th that will be inside and outside, and we will need lots of help to try and get it going. We'll also have a soup sale as a part of it. All that's going to be, so we're going to need some help. And one of the things is that we do usually do, last year was less baskets, but we do a lot of baskets. And so now we have to get the baskets together a month ahead of time. So we are starting to gather items for baskets now. And we don't know exactly what the baskets will be, but we are gathering items for baskets now, so you can start bringing that items in and look for the newsletter for more details. But I did want to take some time to sort of just tell you what that plan is, because it's so different. If you have any questions, I'll try and answer for them after the service today. Offer to God the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and they've got thy vows unto the Most High. stand if you are able. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, to Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep your peace. Hallelujah.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. The gift of God for the people of God. Thank you.
First communion prayer will be found on page 15. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Teresa asked, her kids are a little concerned about beginning the school year, so I'm sure we'll have other kids as we get closer. So she asked if they could, we could say a special prayer for them. If they'd come up now, please. Let us pray. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase and begin another school year. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged, sorrowful, or afraid. Raise them up when they fall. And in your heart may your peace, which passes understanding, abide all the days of their lives. Amen.
Amen.
Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.